Like the pastor would say, my job here is very simple. And you know, the pastor, he says that when he comes after someone else ministers, he comes to give us prayer points. So the pastor is like, my job here tonight is very simple. I'll give us just one prayer point. We'll pray for just 2-3 minutes. You know, we're a praying church, but today we won't pray much. If you want to continue praying, you can continue praying in your house. He said one prayer point, right? 2-3 minutes. I don't know if you've noticed. I have noticed. 30 minutes later, we're still praying. And thank God for the media department. They project the prayer points here. When I raise my head up, I see prayer point number 16. Told us just one prayer point. I am not understanding. The pastor, God is really helping the pastor. Recently, he has been invited to a series of events to come and minister. Today is in Istanbul, tomorrow is in Ankara, next tomorrow is in Izmir. Even next week, Dubai. Pastor, you might find yourself very soon preaching in Egypt.
Amen.
Oh, amen. Pastor, you are in the spirit more than I am. I want to say something. I cannot teach you how to do your job. Pastor, you can read any verse of the Bible when you go to Egypt, but please, don't read Exodus chapter 14, verse 13. It says, the Egyptians you see today, you shall see them tomorrow. Pastor, please. I want you to come back to Turkey by God's grace. This is the week of love. This is the week of Valentine. It is the week to celebrate couples. And the church had a Valentine service just 5 days ago. And we celebrated it. Many people were very happy about it, that the church celebrated it. Brother Henry in particular was kind of very, very happy because since last year, July, his wife had already made this year's Valentine's plan. Since last year, July, she told Brother Henry, baby, we will go to this country, we will travel to this country, we will visit this country. She made a heavy budget for Brother Henry. Brother Henry quickly remembered the verse of the Bible that says, consult with the elders and you shall get wisdom. He came and met the elders in church. Daddy Mayando gave him an advice. He said, you know, we have the men's choir now. Join the men's choir. To the glory of God, Brother Henry is now a bona fide member of the men's choir. He went back home. He told his wife, he said, baby, that trip you'll have to cancel it. What Brother Henry doesn't know is that she didn't cancel it. She only postponed it till their wedding anniversary. Brother Henry, your wedding anniversary is coming very soon. So, you have to do more than you did last year. You know, the only thing you did last year, you just appreciated your wife on Facebook. I know, because you tagged me. Nigeria is in a, I don't know if most of us know, we are facing economic recession now. The rate of unemployment is increasing. And I have a cousin who graduated like 6 years ago. Till now, he still hasn't gotten a job. He has written, he has gone for several, he has done several job applications, but still nothing. He always gets rejection letter, refusal letter. And there was one refusal letter he got earlier this year. And he was so frustrated, out of frustration, he decided to reply the rejection letter. He wrote a reply and sent it back to the company. He sent me a copy of it, I'm going to read it. Yeah. This is not me, this is my cousin. Well, thank you for your letter written on the 10th January 2017. After careful consideration, I regret to inform you that I am unable to accept your refusal to offer me employment with your company. For 6 years, I have been particularly fortunate in receiving an unusual large number of rejection letters. So because of my huge experience in being a rejected and disappointed candidate, it is impossible now for me to accept any refusal anymore. Despite your company's outstanding qualifications, your rejection does not meet my own criteria. Therefore, I am starting work with your company, whether you like it or not, on Monday, 16th January 2017. My cousin has now been arrested for trespassing on private property. I said this is the week of Valentine. And it was so special in our church because we have newly wedded couples among us. During the Valentine service, we had three couples we celebrated. And we still have them with us today.
Please, if you hear your names, just raise God, raise your hand and praise God, okay? We have Brother James and Sister Rachel Akapo.
Praise God.
We have Brother Hima and Sister Glory Ogbu. Ah, hallelujah. Your husband is not here today. Oh, he's on duty. Which duty? He's on duty. We have Brother Felix in and Sister Catherine Oben. Two of them, the couples, the Ogbus and the Oben had their wedding, their marriage ceremony back in their country. But their couples had theirs here. And I was the MC at their reception. I'm very happy that I was a part of their marriage ceremony. Because now I see that the Lord is blessing them. The Lord has started blessing them with their own Isaac. The very first time I realized, I noticed that Sister Rachel was pregnant. You know, I saw her and I am never at a loss of words. But at that particular moment, I was at a loss of words. The only thing I was saying was, wow, wow, wow. Just like an ambulance. Wow, wow, wow. After that, I ran into her husband, Brother James. I said, Brother James, God is really using you. I asked him, I said, Brother James, is this the only Isaac to come, or shall we wait for others? He replied me with a verse in the Bible. He said, the Lord has promised me he will make me a father of many nations. I said, a man of great ambition. The person I would advise the most and say the greatest prayer for is Sister Rachel. The man you have married is a man of great ambition. He will definitely be a father of many nations. And that makes you a mother of many nations. God will empower you. God will strengthen you. This journey you have embarked on is not going to be easy. And I want to say, maybe one day you might be in your house when you count all your children, Akapo 1, Akapo 2, 21, 23, 54, 56, and you're like, where is Akapo 42? And you're in the house. The doors are locked. Don't look for that. Just go and check. Maybe, you know, children, go and check maybe inside the washing machine or refrigerator. I was the MC at a reception in Nigeria. But before I come to that, I was sitting just over there, and one of the ushers went to meet one of the daddies that he should go and repark his car outside there. And he made me remember the way things are being done in Nigeria, these kind of things. You know, in events, you have a very large crowd and you don't know whose car is which. So it's the MC that gives the announcement whenever they need someone to go and repark his or her car. And the way the MC gives the announcement depends on the kind of car. Now let's say, I'm going to demonstrate it. Now the MC gets the information, he gets the letter, the paper, that someone should go and repark his car. Thank you. Please, if you are the owner of this car, Mercedes Maybach S-Class Series, S600, 24th of July, 2019 model. Please, we beg of you, go and repark your car. We apologize. The MC apologizes. He begs. He pleads. But if you are of the other category, this is how the MC gives you the announcement. Thank you. If you are the owner of this device, Tofash 1825, Turkish model. Your device is blocking a G-Class SUV 2022 model. My brother, that is wickedness. Why remove that thing from there? I was the MC at an event in Nigeria. It was a wedding ceremony, the wedding reception. The bride was the one in charge of all the preparations. And, you know, the newly wedded couples can testify to it. When your day is coming, you get nervous. And maybe because of the excitement, you're kind of like, I hope nothing goes wrong. That kind of a thing. So she was like that. And in order to calm her nervousness down, she decided to engrave on her wedding cake the verse of the Bible that had always brought her comfort. The verse could be found in 1 John 4:18. It says, there is no fear in love, but perfect love drives away fear. She called the wedding, the catering company. All arrangements were made, and the wedding day came. Everything was good, and I had been told that when the wedding cake comes, just read whatever verse of the Bible you see on the wedding cake. The reception came and the wedding day came, the wedding cake came. It was not my fault, so I just read what was in it. And unfortunately, the catering company, instead of 1 John 4:18, they wrote the verse that could be found in John 4:18. And I read it out. It says, you have had 5 husbands, and the husband you have now is not your husband. It was not my fault. I didn't get paid, unfortunately. But I took the cake home, I ate half of it, I saw the rest. That was how I got paid. Before I leave here, I would like to give a word of advice to the newly wedded couples. You know, I cannot live here without... When I come here, don't just think I just come here to make us laugh. No. 2 months ago, I came and I said something. God used me to prophesy into you, into lives. I said something. Babies are coming, right? I said that. Do you remember? And now we have babies. With the Akapos, we have Isaac. With the Obus, we have Jeremiah. With the Oben, we have David. Do you want Adedoran? David Adedoran? You have David Adedoran. So now I want to give you a word of advice. Please listen very carefully. Take it very seriously. My uncle is so religious. He's so religious that he named his first child Partnership with Christ. That was the name he gave his first child. Partnership with Christ. You know, the Bible says, meditate upon these things and give yourself wholly to them so that men may see your progress. The Bible also says, this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth. Meditate therein day and night. My uncle named his second child, join this chariot. The end is near. And it is time we start, we should start try to understand the things we are committed to spiritually. So to the newly wedded couples, I want to tell you there's nothing wrong when you give birth to children and you begin to name them after the books written by the pastors that inspire you the most. Or after Bible verses, your favorite Bible verses, or Bible quotes. Give your children names like, now that you are born again, the Holy Spirit and you, prophecy, how faith works. And if it's the Sunday school manual we use there that inspires you, name your child Sunday school manual. And let me tell you, if you give birth to twins, name them tithe and offering. If you give birth to triplets, name them tithe, offering, and welfare offering. But before the third name, you have to ask Mommy Banda for permission. She's the one in charge of welfare offering in the church. These are powerful names. These are names that even the devil will hear and shout, blood of Jesus. These are names that your children will grow up with. The Bible says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, you will not depart from it. Imagine, Sister Glory, imagine naming your child none of these diseases. Or the teachers you see today. Or it is finished. And if it's not a Bible verse that inspires you, if it's one old chapter, name your child Leviticus chapter 1. And if you're giving birth to like 9 children, and people start complaining, this is too much. Even the pastor comes and says, brother, sister, this is too much. Don't listen to them. Give birth to the 10th one and name the 10th one. This ministry will continue.